What's up, everybody? It's me, it's Alexis Maurice, and...
True Hollywood.
And it is time for an all-new episode of Hollywood Happening, so go ahead and pour yourself a glass of wine. Tonight, we're drinking Woodbridge, a Chardonnay 2013 edition. Put on some lipstick, pull up a chair, because it's time for us to discuss the latest happenings in Hollywood. We've missed you guys so much that we decided we wanted to film two back-to-back new episodes. Because we've been gone for so damn long. Back to back. Boom, cha-boom, cha-boom. While we take our first sip, go ahead and like this video, share it on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Snapchat, Glide, all of that. Why do you do that? You smell, you see other people doing it. That's all.
You know Hollywood, so you know I gotta.
We need some cheese and some crackers. All
right, I'm gonna have the next episode.
And some grapes. So NeNe Leakes decided to shock us all by announcing that she will not be returning for season 8 of The Real Housewives of Atlanta.
Yes.
I can't say that I'm surprised.
I'm
it
shocked.
It might be time for her to spread her wings, as she says, to do something different.
Yes, hair.
Or what is that? Yes, NeNe.
Yes, hair. Mm-hmm. Can I read to y'all what she said on her Instagram?
What did she say, Trey?
Did she delete it? No, she did not. Okay. No. She said, "This is so hard for me to type. I cry as I do so. I am so grateful for the love and the laughs. Thank you so much for everyone that has watched and supported me over the years on an amazing platform. Mm-hmm. With lots of thoughts and prayer, I've decided to step out on faith, not fear. No more Real Housewives of Atlanta for me."
And she said, that's it. Now, I'm hoping that at least... Now, she did say that, you know, every now and then she might turn up and play with the girls a little bit. After she said she played the girls.
I'm emotional.
Yeah, it is going to be awkward. Hopefully, she'll be at least on the first two episodes so we can have
a... I wanted to see how Kim Fields interact.
Okay, so let's talk about that. So, just in case you guys didn't know, there's rumors circulating that Kim Fields, Tootie from The Facts of Life, it's actually
Regine.
Test screening for The Real Housewives of Atlanta.
Regine
from Living Single. Uh-huh. We are living single. Ooh, in a honest kind of world. I'm glad I got my... Keep your head up, boy. Keep your head up. That's right. Whenever this tough gets up, you gotta jump. When my whole boy standing to my left and my right.
Jump, jump.
It's that right glue. We are check, check, check it out, check, check.
Single. Go ahead, Queen Latifah.
But Kim Fields is screen testing for The Real Housewives of Atlanta. I don't know. How do you feel about that?
I want to see it. I want to see it, but I want to see.
Really?
I want to see her and NeNe interact. Now, rumor has it is that Kim Fields' husband is on the down low. So that's the story that.
Oh my God!
TV
why would you even
on.
Say that?
That's what I'm.
Are you serious?
Yes. Supposedly her husband is down.
Oh,
so that's reports
Lord,
what they're going to try to
no.
play off of.
No. I'm not for that. Nah. I'm against it.
But Claudia
is out.
Out the motherfucking show.
She's out.
She ain't nobody's housewife.
I'm sorry to hear that. But I like little Claudia. Hopefully she'll show up from time to time.
Child.
Or whatever. But NeNe, maybe NeNe will show up from time to time. She even said that. Now NeNe.
Let's bring back Sheree.
But if I don't want to see Sheree, if NeNe ain't gonna be on the show.
Why not Sheree?
Because
come back and slap that. So is NeNe and Kim still gonna have their show?
I don't know. I was gonna ask you the same damn question, Trey, because we, you know, it was this big to-hoo-ha to do that NeNe and Kim were gonna be having their show. I don't
Kim's
know if it's been shot. I don't know if it's in production. I don't know what's going on with it. We haven't heard anything else about it. But congratulations to NeNe. Now, NeNe did tease us the day when she released the announcement saying that she's going to be returning to primetime. Since then, we've learned that she's going to be on a variety show with Betty White, Golden Girl Betty White. In addition to that, I think Anthony Anderson is going to be on the variety show as well. So congratulations to NeNe. One thing, I may not necessarily
she's
be a fan of NeNe all the time, of her shenanigans, because I feel that NeNe doesn't like to own sometimes her stake or whatever, what she contributes to the chaos. But one thing I can't knock her for, she be on her hustle.
That's what I be saying.
NeNe be on her hustle. And I'm happy for her. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm pretty sure that's a quick million. 1.5, what's she getting? 1.5 or 1 million?
You decided to jump out my head.
Insurance. I think it was 1 or 1.5 million she was actually. Some people are saying that she left because of money and things of that particular nature. But I don't think necessarily that that's the case. I mean, for me, that's a quick million I could make real quick by just giving up 6 to 8 weeks of my life to be filmed. That's, you know.
Bruh.
But what she was enduring during those 6 to 8 weeks was enough. So what do you think about the show now? So we got Candy, who's definitely coming back. Well, none of these things have been confirmed actually, but Candy returning, Phaedra more than likely returning, Kenya will definitely more than likely return.
Portia.
More than likely, she's getting her peach back.
Yeah, I mean, she was on every episode last season. I mean, I might as well have her with a peach, but I mean.
Oh, whatever. Claudia's gone. So, is that four of them?
You have
Cynthia. Cynthia, too. So, you got five. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, you got five.
That's going about to be the shiznick. You hear me?
Yeah, but this whole thing with Peter and this.
I don't think her and Peter are together no more. If you realize, I ain't seen no picture
they
posted.
They was together. Out there in LA.
Okay. Was Jocelyn and Stevie J. I mean, hey.
Child, did you hear that Jocelyn and Carly Rae got into some kind of fight here in Atlanta not too long ago?
Did you hear that Nicki Minaj was fumbling up with somebody else after the BET Awards? Did you hear that?
Get out of here. Mm-hmm. Really? Mm-hmm. Catch that juice. Mm-hmm. Ooh, let me take a sip of my wine, girl.
Nicki Minaj was up caking with somebody else.
Nicki and Meek Mill don't look like a real couple in my personal
opinion.
They
look like they're trying to pull a Jay-Z and Beyonce to me, you know, the rapper.
No shade, but he's not really cute.
He ain't cute at all. Yeah. Neither are some other people that.
But anywho, so congratulations to Nene. I'm looking forward because now is around the time that they actually start filming here in Atlanta or whatever. Usually this month.
I'm going to look out for some casting calls so I can be in the background looking at somebody's restaurant in my phone while they arguing over there. And I'm
pretending like you don't know what the hell is going on. Now, some other shakeup on reality television is Donald Trump.
Fire!
So just in case you guys didn't realize or didn't know, Donald Trump announced finally, after several years and of teasing of several elections in the past, that he was going to be running for president, he decided to actually run for president this time for the Republican Party.
Yes.
So, Donald Trump announced his presidency. Donald. He let everybody know that he's a billionaire, although some people say he doesn't have as much money as he says that he has.
Allegedly.
Donald Trump recently shake shit up when he made the comment
shaking
about
the table.
Shaking the damn table.
Shaking the table.
Is that Kim
Michelle? That's Kim Michelle with Carly Rae. You ain't fucking tell me that he. Ooh, she's shaking the table.
But she was saying, but Donald Trump made some statements where he was basically saying that that Mexicans were, you know, illegal immigrants and that they are tearing our country apart and that they are rapists and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So everyone was all up in arms because Donald Trump said this. Now, mind you, Donald Trump has been saying some ridiculous things for several years, as long as I've known him. I mean, as long as we've known him, I feel like he's a friend in my head and Wendy Williams.
You know, Oprah.
I love Donald Trump, though. I ain't gonna tell you, I really like Donald Trump because I can respect a man who says what he wants.
Let me give y'all a list real quick of the things of the individuals that Alexis Marisa loves. Donald Trump. Wendy Williams.
Kenya Moore.
I wanted to say it so bad. The only one that I can agree with. Well, no, I like Wendy.
Right.
But it's Oprah. That's the only one I agree with.
I love Oprah.
But Kenya Moore and
get off Kenya. Give Kenya a hard time for some of the same stuff that other people have done more ridiculous things in the media. Kenya Moore don't be doing all of that.
She be flirting with other people, man.
Well, like I said, just like she said on the reunion, people also said that Nene was flirting with Peter. And you can't sit here and tell me that people did not say that Nene was flirting with Peter. Everybody was saying that when it first happened.
We never saw it, but people
were saying it on the show, Trey. We saw it. People said, why Nene all, you know, why she be feeling some type of way? People said that Nene used to flirt with Peter. They used to say,
don't. He was a whore anyway.
That's what people.
He get
hit
from gays behind the club.
Trey, don't put that out there. That is not true. Don't say that. We trying to come up. You making people hate us already. My gosh.
I know somebody who gave Peter the head behind.
Oh, Trey, stop. I ain't lying. There ain't nobody finna go down that road. That Donald Trump.
I was just saying.
Okay, Donald Trump. Said what he said about the Mexicans.
Head is head.
And everybody is upset.
That's to a Jamaican.
NBC said, you're fired.
Fired.
So they have removed all Trumps from Celebrity Apprentice. Now, when you talk about him running for presidency, they had to remove him in the first place. Mm-hmm. Because of the fact that they can't provide him a platform where he can potentially... where they can potentially be seen as biased and giving him more time without giving all of the other candidates time as well too.
Right.
So they had to let him go anyway.
Okay.
But it was attached to the fact that he said what he said about the Mexicans. And that's the surprising thing when it comes to the Republican Party and those individuals who declared their presidency. He's number two.
He gonna need them though.
He's number two, Trey. Yeah, and you know what? I'm gonna be honest with you, and some of y'all may hate me for even saying this. I'm interested to see what Donald Trump actually has to say. I'm interested to see what he has to say about his candidacy for president. As of right now, I'm riding with Hillary. But Hillary need to talk to us and let us know what's going on instead of not talking to us.
I'm not voting.
But what? That's the craziest thing you could have ever said. You're not voting. Why are you not voting?
I ain't voting.
You don't know yet. You just haven't heard anything. All right, now we just
everything got... I needed done, Barack Obama done did.
I've seen a lot of people say we need to change the law and allow presidents to serve more than two terms. And we need to elect Barack Obama again for a third
term. Yeah, I need him to come
back. I'm all for that. I'll drink to that. But anywho, his approval ratings have actually gone up tremendously. President Barack Obama.
Yes.
But, you know, and come so on, not only has NBC...
Come on, Michelle.
Not only...
She should run for president.
Shut up, Trey. I'm trying to get through this.
Yeah, I'm sorry. She should
run for president. Said that we need to mind the time on the topics.
Right, you're right. My bad.
So not only have they removed him from Celebrity Apprentice, but they... NBC is also... Univision is also canceled his Miss USA pageant. So that will no longer be aired as well, which was supposed to be shot, I think, in a couple of weeks or whatever the case
may be. Because he looked forward to those.
Donald Trump said NBC's weak, everybody's weak, and he said that...
Somebody
is raping the people, okay? Now, when you go to Fusion.com and you look at all of these interviews that he said, these magazine articles, well, it's alarming that these women are getting raped. Somebody's raping them. Donald told Don Lemon on CNN, somebody's raping them.
Somebody raping the women.
He said NBC's weak. He said Macy's is a small business. They cracked up under pressure. It's okay. He said it's a small business for me anyway. It's just ties. Oh, whatever. I'm not even that, you know, he's not even that pressed about it. I love Donald Trump. I ain't gonna tell you that. I really like Donald Trump.
I'm interested
just to see what he says, because him running for president is bringing a level of celebrity, I think, to this whole presidential campaign thing. We're seeing reality TV, big business merge into politics. So I'm interested just to see what he has to say, what he's gonna be platforming. I guarantee you these debates... The Republican Party debates, usually I don't even watch those until it's just between the two final candidates. Or the final candidates. Then we got Christie from Jersey, who announced that he's going to be running, but he's running independent. He's not running affiliated with
the
party.
The guy from Texas.
Jeb Bush? He won it.
No. There was a Hispanic guy from Texas.
Mm.
He spoke... I think Obama's first term.
Second.
Might have been
second. Is he Democrat or Republican?
I think he's Democrat. No, he had his Republican. Daughter. His daughter was in the audience. She was one who was doing her hair.
He's a twin? Is he a twin?
He might be. During his speech in Texas, his daughter was the one who was, in the audience.
Is he from Texas?
He's in Texas.
Okay.
He should run for president. I will go for him.
I will say that I think this presidential election is going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting. It's going to be entertaining. And I also think it's going to be pivotal.
Very.
With the different issues that we have going on in America right now, seeing how that transition is going to, hand over from President Barack Obama to whoever is going to be taking on. Right now, I think Hillary is going to win by a landslide, because the Republican Party has too many people you know, who's declaring their presidency. Donald Trump is number two. That's all I'm saying. And all he's saying is that we have a serious immigration problem. So he did try to clean up everything. He was saying that he didn't necessarily say that it was the Mexicans. Uh-huh. But when he says that the United States has a serious immigration problem, he said they're coming from everywhere. He said, we don't know if they're coming from Mexico. We don't know if they're coming from the Middle East. He said, we don't know where they're coming from, but they're coming from somewhere or whatever. And we need to do a better job with our border control. So, you know, we'll see what he says. We'll see how it goes with Donald Trump. But I thought that was actually kind of interesting. You know,
there's another political debate going on.
About?
With America versus Iggy. Iggy Azalea. So,
give it up.
I don't understand.
I'll let you talk about this.
I don't understand why people hate her so much. You know,
she, you understand?
I don't, you don't understand why people hate her so much. I mean, she's just a girl from another country, just trying to come in and just make something of herself.
She's trying to make some coins in the United
but
States.
But what she got to stop doing, for one, she got to just stop making stupid statements. She just got to stop saying certain stuff. Mm-hmm. So the other day, Iggy went on this tweet and blah, blah, blah. Like, if you're a hardcore rapper, be a rapper. If you feel like media is coming for you, do like Eminem used to do. He used to make a diss tape about it. You know what I'm saying? Nas, me just diss about it.
She can't
stop getting on Twitter, blase and blase and a blase. So her and Britney Spears has a song together.
Mm-hmm. I don't even know what the song is. Pretty Girls or Girls?
Pretty Girls Around the World.
I don't even know what it is.
Hot song. You and I have mentioned before that, you know what, Iggy, you know what, you have made these mistakes. Your tour has got canceled.
She just
you
need to stop.
You need to, no, if anything, we thought, okay, well, maybe she might be able to go on tour with Britney Spears. This is a good level for her. She can open up for Britney, blase, blase. You know what I'm saying? She done fucked that up.
Right.
She done fucked that up. Right. By her stupid statements about the single, feeling like they didn't promote it correctly.
She, no, not they. She said Britney. She said that she was not going to kiss nobody's ass to make them get up and promote a song that both of them basically recorded. So everyone thought, well, not everyone, Iggy thought that this song between her, this collaboration between her and Britney Spears would be like this... the it song of the summer, basically.
It's a hot song. I actually love it. I love the song.
They shot a video for, if I'm not mistaken.
Love the video.
Ooh, that was thing. Oh, God. Mm. Mm. They shot a video for it. But the song is basically flop. People don't know nothing about it or whatever. And Iggy is blaming Britney Spears. Are they calling back? No. Oh. They're calling. Don't answer that phone, Trey.
Okay.
Don't answer the phone. So Iggy is basically saying it's not her fault, it's Britney's fault. She said it's difficult to send a song up the charts without additional promo and TV performances, etc. Unfortunately, I'm just featured. So Britney basically said, what did Britney say? Britney said the ultimate shame. Real white girl. She said, can't wait to get back to Vegas. So thankful I have shows for the rest of the year to look forward to. Pow, you want a piece of me?
That was shady, Britney Spears. That was so shady. But that came after, like, Iggy was doing all these tweets. Like, yeah. What I hate is when a celebrity tweets another celebrity, and that celebrity ain't even tweeting you back.
Right.
Like, why the fuck you all in my mentions, bitch? Like, I'm not even talking to you, and you're going in.
Iggy said, at Britney Spears, I'm sure you would have enjoyed some extra performance, etc. of the song. Am I the bad guy for wishing we had done more? Iggy said, my comment is factual. It applies to any song. I don't have to suck the woman's asshole 24/7 to be her friend. Bye, girls. And then that's when Britney said what she said. It's like, I got shows in Vegas. I'm booked. How about you? Iggy, we know you're not booked because you canceled everything. Okay? Iggy. And I don't want to talk about it anymore, Trey.
Oh, Iggy.
I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Pobrecita. That was in Hispanic.
No, it was in Spanish. Don't say in Hispanic.
That was in Spanish.
It was in Spanish. Yeah, what did Donald you say? Trump, do you even know what that. You said?
Poracita, poor thing, and then feminine. But yeah. Yes.
Estupido. Punta. Punta is estupido.
Ooh, that yes. Bitch is stupid.
Stupid bitch.
Está bien. Si, está bien.
Okay. All right, so we're talking about song flops. So just to switch gears just a little bit more, something that broke my heart over the last couple of days is to hear that Bobby Christina has been moved to hospital. Trey.
What? I'm
chilling. You know, we're going to be respectful.
I'm respectful.
And but... sit up and let's address this with some class. Oh. Okay? Bobby Christina was moved to hospice care during this week. The good news is the Browns and the Houstons are getting along right now.
Amazing.
The surprising thing, though, is that criminal charges have been filed by the protector of her estate or whatever against Nick. Is that her?
Yeah,
her husband. We don't know that. We don't know if that's her husband or not.
She says a husband. All we know, Houston said it was a husband. That's a husband.
All we know is that he got access to her coins.
He put a ring on it.
And he be transferring funds. And the sum of $11,000
That's their
like
account.
That.
So why would you try to push charges now because she's going to hospice? Then you want to bring up these.
Then you want to bring up these
this teeth missing, these bruises here. She's been in the hospital for 6 months.
Those things, half of the year. Those things had been mentioned before, but nobody paid attention to them.
Now she's about to die. Now you want to bring it up? Please, that's some bullshit.
Well, I mean, well, you have to understand, I think the executor of the estate or the protector, whatever they call the person, they just took over, Trey. They just took over, I think, because of the fact that she has been transferred to hospice care. And usually, for those of you who don't know, when a person is in hospice, there's basically no more that the physicians can do for the person. The hospice comes in just to make that person more comfortable as we basically await their transition. Mm-hmm. We await their death.
Yeah.
So I think now that that's happened, someone has taken over the state because I think Bobby Christina has $2 million that she received from her mom's estate. She was scheduled to receive another $10 million, I think, when she turned 25.
Well, she didn't quite make that.
Yeah. Whatever she turned a certain age, and then she's going to get the rest of the inheritance after this. But now that she's possibly transitioning on to be with the Lord, you know, there's the Whitney's estate is that question, and we need to find out if she really is married to this man or not. And he's been transferring money out of the account into his account, and he done got out of rehab, and he's been basically doing the same tricks, drinking and stuff that he was doing before. Mm-hmm. They still have not allowed him to see her. Mm-hmm. So ever since she's been in the hospital, he's not.
So what you're telling me is you don't sue me, and I can't even see her. Tell me, have you seen?
Well, they're not suing, honey. Criminal charges have been filed. So now they have a responsibility to see if those claims are actually true. It's an unfortunate situation. Whitney, Lord, honey. Whitney. It's tough. I really am. It's so sad to see this happening. But I will say this. The Lord has the final say. They can remove Bobby Christina off of all of those things. But if she still continues to breathe on her own, there's a hope. There's hope that something can happen. When my father went to his, when he had his aneurysm and he, you know, lost everything, his brain functions went dead, he was on life support. And when we removed life support, he shortly after died. Now, if they remove the life support and that girl is still living, there's a possibility that The Lord is the only person that's going to wake that girl up. The only person that's going to wake that girl up. And a part of me, and I'm hoping, I'm praying for a miracle that she wakes up out of this. Because, well, we need to know what the hell happened, first of all.
She tried to kill herself.
We don't know that. Reports are saying that he beat her, that there was some type of accident, and then there's a possibility. Trey, we have a responsibility to investigate these things.
And I have investigated.
You ain't investigating nothing. You ain't got none of the evidence in this here apartment.
Let me tell you.
You ain't got nothing.
Bobby Christina was going through a lot.
She has.
Missing her mom, being on drugs, being in a relationship where people criticized her. She was tired. She wanted to go out just like her mama did. She laid in that damn tub. Took that damn drug.
No, you don't know that.
Drunk that damn alcohol. That. And she said, you know what? Lord, take me. Rather you take me or not take me, this is what happened. Now, they want
to
bring
her back. Well, he didn't take her. Because if she was supposed to be dead, she would be dead. Because
the flesh, the human, the people, decided to put her on a machine.
Child. I'm not even going there with you. Moving along, prayers for Bobby Christina.
Yes, definitely.
And she's, you know, if I will say this, if in fact that he did harm that girl, the truth will come out, Trey. We're gonna be right back
here. You ain't never seen the thing.
We're gonna be coming right back here, and I'm gonna be saying, boom.
You ain't never seen Thin Line Between Love and Hate. Have you never seen Thin Line Between Love and Hate?
I saw that movie.
And wasn't she crazy and put bruises on
her? So you trying to say Bobby Christina crazy?
Possibly.
Right. Now see, you know what? I'm not even finna continue
saying that. People do those things.
Moving along.
So you're telling people don't do those things?
You're being disrespectful.
I'm saying, you're saying people don't do those things?
You're being disrespectful.
Okay.
People do those things, but Bobby Christina doesn't have a history or a track record.
We don't know what she has a history of, because Whitney made sure that things were handled. This shit ain't go out of control until Whitney was gone. Next topic.
It's a lot of baby news and stuff like that. I can't believe you.
I don't like when people fight God. So if God was doing what he was doing, don't sit here and hold on
to this girl. But if you get in a car accident and something happened to you, I'm going to say don't put his ass on nothing. Don't put him on nothing. Let him die.
No.
Let him die. That's what I'm going to say.
Put me on something long
enough. I was all for it. You just said when people interfere with God.
Listen to what I'm saying.
No.
Put me on a support long enough for my family to come see me. And then let me go if I have to go.
But you was just talking about the last episode that you a love of life and save me.
No,
and
all I'm talking about getting shot.
It's the same thing. Maybe it was time for the Lord meant for that bullet to go cave in your chest.
But I survived without the machine. Did he survive without the machine? All right. Because God was not ready to take his life. Even though he done committed whatever crime he done committed, he done did what he did. God's not ready to take his life. Do not fight God. If I was to get in this situation, hold on to me until my family can come see me, but then let me go.
Tell all them lies.
Don't hold on.
He gonna be all in his spirit man gonna be all in the room. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. I'm Hollywood. I got stuff to do. Go call Brandy. Da 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 da. Child boo. I don't even believe that, Trey. Anywho, there's a lot of baby news going on. We talking about death. Let's talk about all this birth stuff. So, catch this tea. Mm-hmm. Bristol Palin.
That fat bitch. I mean, that fat bitch. I mean, that child.
Oh, gosh. I have a vision for us. Yes. And you're just destroying that vision for us. We can't be on television and you saying all of these
Why
things.
Not? This is to get views. What do you mean?
Child. I don't agree. She already there.
You can't separate
us.
We combine by the hip.
No, we are not conjoined here.
Yes, we are.
No, we are not. Anyway, so Bristol Palin. Sarah Palin, former, candidate.
Former girl who they cheated and lied to still be on Dancing with the Stars, but no, she should have been kicked off and Brandy should have stayed on there. They tried that shit. But
he
go
got
ahead.
Personal grudges.
Go ahead, I do.
He's holding personal grudges.
Go ahead. Because no, damn with her big ass, should I have been still on that stage. She could not dance. She moved like this.
Bristol Palin. So she is pregnant again for the second time.
That's all she's
doing. And she's not married. Now, catch this juice. The thing that's interesting. Now remember, she was engaged to a man a couple of months ago.
Damn,
he broke it off. They broke it off. They were supposed to get married. The family still had the reception. Told the people they can still come eat the food.
White folks, fish up there in Alaska. White folks,
all kind of stuff like that. And now she pregnant. So it makes me wonder.
She got pregnant that night.
Has she been cheating? Is this man's? Because she has not come out and said that's man's child.
It's our whole entire housewife, I tried.
And she's been wearing these purity rings, going around talking about abstinence and all that kind of stuff like that. And she pregnant again. Bristol girl, this is bad publicity for y'all.
How many she got?
This is her second one. Pending second child. She already got one that she had out of wedlock. Tammy Roman.
That's a sin, though.
Tammy Roman from Basketball Wives. She's pregnant.
Amen.
By her boyfriend. Mm-hmm. Is that her husband or boyfriend? I don't know.
The man she with.
The young gentleman she's with. Now, she remember Tammy has two grown daughters. So she's pregnant again. So she's now saying Kim and Kanye reveal that they're having a boy, or whatever the case may be. You remember, we still have some doubts if she's really pregnant or not, because she ain't really showing that baby bump.
My baby bump
bigger than hugs or whatever. DMX. got arrested in New York for not paying his child support or whatever. He's back like several thousands of dollars back child support, so he got arrested. And Chris Brown has recently filed filed for custody of his little girl.
You know, I still want to know about that.
Like, what do you mean?
I still, you know, did he get a test? Like,
paternity test?
Yes,
did. Well, yeah, he did, because remember, he agreed to keep the baby up under wraps. As long as it didn't come forward, he would continue to take care of it. But she broke silence, or the story broke. So therefore, now, you know, he wanted basically his baby to stay out of the fact that he has a child out of the media. Whether it's for image, purpose, or maybe he just didn't want the world to know. Mm. It came out, it leaked. Mm. I don't know if there's some beef going on. This is a developing story, because I don't know all the details, but I do know that he's filed for custody and stuff like this. I don't know what's going on with that. Maybe next episode we'll get into that just a little bit more. But that's a lot of the baby news that's going on.
I don't
on
think
right
that's
now.
His baby.
Why you say that? What's the baby name? Royal?
I thought it was Lil' Kim baby.
Oh, okay.
What was that? Rain?
That's Rain. I think her baby's name is Rain.
That's too much.
I don't know. But anyway.
North. Royal. Rain. Blue North Royal Rain. God, they might come with an airline. A movie. Blue North Royal Rain.
A good reality show,
right? The dance and the celebrity babies. Oh my god, like, do you think that might happen?
No,
that might.
No,
Beyonce anyway, ain't gonna put blue in.
Thank y'all so much
show.
For watching this episode of Hollywood Happens.
Chris Brown put his baby in the reality show.
No, he won't. He, you know, Kim, he didn't even want to wear the
North.
He had baby.
North gonna be the da 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 da. No,
there was this picture of North and Mason, I believe.
Yes, that was so cute. It was walking around like they own Hollywood.
No, but wait. It was a picture that was saying Bruce just walked in and they was looking like this.
What the fuck is that?
It was so funny. That picture was so funny. Speaking of the Kardashians, NeNe, I forgot to say that NeNe made her debut on the Kardashian Game.
Yes, she did.
That's big. Not only does she have was she cashing a Trump check, but she was also now cashing a Kardashian check
and
on top of
it. She's still cashing it. She still get royalty from it, because I mean, she is the fucking voice face of Real Housewives of Atlanta.
She is the highest paid of the reality series, the Housewives series. Brandi Glanville from Beverly Hills, she's not going to be on there anymore either. She's walking away.
She should, because she's stupid.
I like Brandi. You know, my thing with the whole Real Housewives of Beverly Hills is that actually was my favorite one.
Yeah, I know you told me.
Yeah, and the thing about it is,
the only one I watch is Real Housewives of Atlanta.
Yeah, I watch Beverly Hills, I watch Jersey, and I watch Atlanta. Those are kind of my three.
There are others?
Yeah. Orange County, New York.
Yeah, Miami was kind of stupid.
DC, but it was canceled. But the thing about Brandi and the whole Real Housewives of Beverly Hills is, you know, I felt that Brandi did do some crazy things this season. She slapped Lisa Vanderpump.
Yes.
She threw wine in Aline Davidson's face. Yeah. Ashley from The Young and the Restless. She was constantly bickering with Kyle, which is Kim Richards' sister, which is the aunties of Paris Hilton. Did you see that video where Paris Hilton was on a plane? And they were punking her. The plane was crashed. You have to see it. She was hollering. She was crying. She thought that she was about to die. And it was a prank.
Oh, please show me that.
Yeah, you have to see it. And, you know, there's rumors now that she's actually suing as a result of that.
Girl, it's just a
but
prank.
She was saying her worst fear is flying the plane.
But
crashing.
You fly all the time.
But that's her worst fear of dying from a plane crash.
Why would you still fly if that's your worst fear, girl? You
so what do you think she's supposed to do? Drive
somewhere? She want a check. She need a check.
Trey. Check. You have to see. As a matter of fact, I'm going to post a video on the Hollywood Happenings page. You know, I'm inappropriate.
Is it funny?
Wait a minute. Listen to me. I'm inappropriate.
It's a prank. You don't even prank.
I am inappropriate, so I laugh at stuff that shouldn't be laughed at. And on the video, she was like, oh my God, does it normally do this? And she was, but imagine it. I don't tell you, because I fly frequently and I fly over water frequently, I be thinking about the plane dropping. And what the hell is up with all these shark attacks in North and South Carolina?
I heard about that. And you know, people going to South Carolina this weekend.
For the beach. It's the 4th of July weekend. And
my man, she's going to the actual Charleston, the church where that happened at. She's going there this weekend.
Emmanuel Amy. Yeah. I've been there several times growing up. But just the shark attacks and just the thought of a plane. I fly frequently, Trey. So the thought of a plane crashing over water. You know, you hear about those planes crashing over there in Malaysia. That's a terrible fear of thinking that your plane is going to do this over open sea and there's nothing around you that's going to save you. Mm-hmm. That's kind of scary. But you have to see. I have to show you the video once we stop recording this so you can see the cameras. But anyway, back to Brandon. You know, Brandon is so unforgivable in those girls' eyes. And I don't think that's the case. You know, Brandon didn't do anything any different than anybody else. Granted, she put her hands on somebody. Granted, she threw some wine in somebody's face. But she does it for TV. You know, she's saying that she doesn't know why she does that those things. But she did it for TV. Let's be honest, Brandon. You did it for television, for that it factor. And now the people hate you so much, you decided to walk away from the show. And she's also said that she'll be around, you know. But Kim Richards, Kyle's sister, she's also left from the seat from the show, too. So, I don't know if the Housewives franchise is dying or not. But, anywho, thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Hollywood Happens. We love you, and we will see you guys later on. Ta-ta.
Wherever the girls go.